Good evening. I hear that Chamisa is weighed in on SMM. The SMM saga is a continuing story, and President Mugabe has opened an avenue, perhaps, to go beyond the headlines, to go beyond what we know and what we are told. And I believe that today in Gweru at Mkoba Stadium, Chamisa did allude to the story, and I think I only need to maybe put part of the story where the headline is, I will return SMM to Mawere. Good evening, Rebecca. Good evening, Cliff. And what are the issues related to SMM? I think some people think returning an asset that was raped is the issue, and that my interest is restoration of an asset. But I think we need to appreciate what Honorable Chamisa said, and then be able to pack it, to unpack it, so that all of us can better understand what time it is and what ought to happen. What is being said? What is it that we take home? I think we also have been reminded, I think by President Mugabe, that he is not intending to be restored to his previous position. He is saying that this era, if it's not understood, then it will happen again. And we need to be very, very careful in terms of understanding where justice begins and where justice ends, or ought to end. It is instructive that many people would actually want restoration, retributive justice. And this is what I saw in the story that was shared. It says, addressing thousands of MDC Alliance supporters, MDC President Nelson Chamisa blew Mnangagwa bubble, saying Zimbabwe is not open for business. Maybe we should start there. For the people who are watching and listening, do you think that Zimbabwe is open for business? Is Zimbabwe open for business? The president is fond of saying. What is your take? Is Zimbabwe genuinely open for business? Have the conditions necessary for investment been met? On the one hand, on the political side, Mugabe says, please correct the error before you go for elections. On the business side, it would appear that there is a call for foreign investors who are more than welcome to come into Zimbabwe. Zunaid Moti has hired a British peer born in South Africa, Lord Hayne, former minister in the Labour government, to assist him on Zimbabwean matters. Not a black person. Zunaid Moti is more welcome in Zimbabwe than Mtuma Mawere. The law that permitted the government to take SMM, diabolical as it may be, still remains in the statute books. And Ian, Aaron, it can be open, but we have to sort out in-house issues. Certainly, who is to sort out the in-house issues? They have to wait for elections, or issues that we must address now? Because it should not be about SMM. Mambi says, I doubt if Zimbabwe is open for business. What would take away the doubt, Mambi? Why do you have to doubt in this year of the Lord, 2018, on the 18th of March? TNC, we still have a long way to go before we get there. How do we get there is the question. It's a ZANU government, what business? Do you think SMM can be restored to its former glory, especially looking at the global statutes on business? Anything can be restored, Sean. But if public power is used for improper purposes, then you must sort that out, because meat does not have to invite flies. It is self-evident that anything that is good attracts attention. We all would be chanting, raising slogans, and popping champagne. Alas, that is not the case. Finley Rees, why open business for outsiders instead of opening for the local people? We need an illumination of the mind. Open business is value-centric. If there is value to be done, it shouldn't matter whether you are local or foreign. But genuinely, if there's something that is wrong, let's point it out and deal with it. Johnson Mudukote, Zimbabwe is open for business. Maybe you can explain to Jigora Joe, who say, can someone explain what is meant by Zimbabwe is open for business? He is visiting the indigenization law does not make Zimbabwe open for business. Ian Aaron, change of government will change lives. Infrastructure for investment in Zimbabwe needs a change. Finley Rees, do people know what investment brings? Look at what China did to us. So this is, what does Zimbabwe is open for businessmen. Let's continue reading the article. Hello, Grace. Welcome. Let's continue to read what it then says. This is the president of the MDCT, Advocate Chamisa, who makes this point. He says, how can Mnangagwa say Zimbabwe is open for business? Who closed down? Who closed down those businesses? It's Mnangagwa. That's a finding by Chamisa, that Mnangagwa is a party to the closing of businesses. And Mnangagwa ought to explain, according to Advocate Chamisa, where was he when these businesses were closed? What did he do when the businesses were being closed? Have you ever heard Mnangagwa's voice on the closure of SMM, the placement of SMM under reconstruction? Have you to date ever heard him say so? That under my watch, in the first 100 days, I am going to investigate the facts and circumstances of the closure of SMM. The president has spoken on many other things. President Mugabe, since 2004, did anyone ever hear President Mugabe pronounce an opinion on SMM? Has anyone in the same eloquence that Chamisa has spoken today, in this, with the same clarity that there is an injustice in this whole matter? Have you ever heard President Mugabe, the constitutionalist, making a statement about the constitutional issues that arise from the Reconstruction Act and the actions that led to the closure of the mine under his watch? Did he ever seek a commission of inquiry to investigate the facts and circumstances of SMM? Have you ever heard Mnangagwa pronounce an opinion on what happened in 2004? Or he would say, we have moved on, which is the famous word. If you got a problem with SMM, go to court. Why would somebody push people to court when there is no judgment required to know what is right and what is wrong? Chamisa goes on to say, Mnangagwa shut down butter and other industries and went on to steal Shabani Mashaba mines from Mawere. Chamisa is alleging theft. And when someone alleges, he bears the onus to prove the allegation. Sidion Nyamtumbu, who had closed the doors for business, that we go on mountaintop saying Zimbabwe is open for business. It would have to be somebody who had no constructive knowledge or who was excluded from the Mugabe administration. Surely, if you were part and parcel of the eyes and ears, the mouthpiece of that era, why would you need to pronounce Zimbabwe is open for business as if Mugabe was operating in a glass house? We have heard Mugabe say, why would my wife want to poison somebody? When in truth and fact, we all have been eating food cooked by the same woman who is now being accused of being a witch. Karina Swing, I'm certain that this year, 2018 election, we'll see many amazing and profound changes for Zimbabwe. How could it not? So many beautiful and courageous Zimbabweans are speaking out and sharing their views. We may share views, but the reality on the ground is what it is. Cleopas Makaure, I think Chamisa has a point here. Where was Mnangagwa when these businesses were closed? Where was justice when an unjust law was given life and administered by people who want to proclaim Zimbabwe is open for business today? Jealous cheese, Zimbabwe open for business election gimmick ship in wolfskin. Karina Swing, when I visited there for the first time 2 years back, I saw so many beautiful and strong people, though severely challenged by economy and political policy, doing the best that they were able, and such lovely kindness from most. Simba Muzamba, welcome. Finley, was it AED as the main perpetrator, or it was Chinamasa and Gono? I think by deductive logic and by direct factual matrix, why would the president not be alive to this injustice? Why would we be talking about an unjust law and the former minister of justice sees no evil? Why would other people be arrested for abuse of office, yet no one connected with SMM is under anyone's watch? We have noted. Tinofanira kudzosera chinhu chamawere. I would qualify that and say, Honorable Chamisa should be talking about constitutionalism, rule of law. Otherwise, Mugabe will also say, ndidzoserei chinhu changu. Give me back my power. He is not saying that. He is saying correct the injustice by repealing the act. That my first act would be to repeal this unjust law and leave the issue of Mawere to sort itself out. Why would it be necessary for us to bring back assets that were unlawfully taken? It is like us going to President Mugabe and say, what is your cause of action? He has stated correctly that his cause of action has nothing to do with restoration, but to do with correcting a constitutional infringement, which needs to be corrected as a matter of agency. Otherwise, the promise of independence dissipates, evaporates, when power can be stolen, assets can be stolen with impunity. So when we say Zimbabwe is open for business, the issue of constitutionalism, rule of law, and respect for human and their property rights cannot be far from the proposition of Zimbabwe being open for business. I think it was Adrian Rogers who says the opposite of poverty is not wealth. Maybe I should write it. The opposite, do you agree that the opposite of poverty is not wealth? Thank you, Tinashe, for sharing a SoundCloud where Mavaire, the former minister, again pointed the finger and said, Mnangagwa's hands are in the dispute of SMM. And he is a driving force behind the closure of SMM. I've written something there that may assist. Everyone knows Bernard Mapungwana. Everyone knows that doing business under the old government was difficult. Mnangagwa was not president then. I think the open for business mantra is right in the sense that the environment is free and fair for everyone, outside and local investment. Are you aware, Bernard, that there is a law that still exists, and that law remains what it was when Mnangagwa was Minister of Justice, when Chinamasa was Minister of Justice? It remains there. So please, let's look at facts and let's not look at style and presentation. Why campaign and say the country is open for business while with parliament courts answer, am I wrong? Now, RGM is expressing the rule of law. I'm glad. We are all glad for it, that for the first time, Mugabe is uttering. He is now saying, I know Mnangagwa, but I'm not too sure how much I knew of who he is. Now he's busy revising, recalibrating, relearning, and learning about his life from prison to 2018, to say, I thought I knew who was who. Now it is discovering that is human. How many other things did Mugabe not know, but pretended to know, or was convinced that actually a glass was half empty, when it was half full. How many things do you think President Mugabe was a victim of and never knew the depth of rot that he presided over? Imagine he knew what we know, what Advocate Chamisa is saying. If Mugabe knew that, I don't think he would limit himself to the act of removing him and the manner in which it was orchestrated and the impunity that seems to be associated with this innovation. Removal of Mawere and his links with the company. Then people say, let's move on. Why are you worried about Mugabe? Why are you worried about Mawere? Who is Mawere anyway? He doesn't deserve any rights, and the people of Shawane, they can go hang because we have moved on. Imagine people decided to forget, to lose memory, and only remember the present and what they promise of the future that they don't control, that we are open for business today, but tomorrow we reserve the right to take your business without your knowledge and consent, as we did in the case of Mawere, in the case of Mugabe. Would you be able to reconcile the rhetoric and the true promise? Because if the separation between Mugabe and his mentee was based on principle, on constitutionalism, then people ought to have gone to him without accusing wives, because wives, by nature and operation of life, are influential on whoever their husband is. For us then to be diverted from the core issues that ought to determine the direction of Zimbabwe, because the opposite of poverty cannot be wealth. Some people may not understand what Adrian Rogers said. The opposite of poverty is not wealth. What did he mean? And I can ask you what you think that statement means. Maybe Mugabe was a brand, not a person, so the whole ship must sink. Our problem with him is when I stand up for the justice and our politicians victimize them, we all turn a blind eye on the victimization and in fact choose to make fun of it. It's not only a Zimbabwean problem, Cliff. It's a universal problem. When somebody falls into jeopardy, into trouble, we drive off. We laugh about it. This is not just a Zimbabwean trait. It's a human trait. Now, Bernard, the Company Act law must be reversed. Finally, all along Mugabe knew the word constitutionalism, but chose otherwise, only to recognize it at the 11th hour. That may be so, Finley. But the reality of life is we don't know what we don't know. I think Advocate Chamisa has ignited us to have a conversation on SMM. We may differ, like I do. The issue is not whether Mawere gets his companies back or not. That shouldn't be the case. Advocate Chamisa, he becomes president. Even before he becomes president, he ought to be asking these difficult and troubling questions. I remember the late President Tsvangirai says, Maweri, when I win the election in 2013, I will restore everything to you. I said, no, don't worry about me. Don't wait to go to office. If there's an injury that has been there for a long time, cure the injury. This is what it is. Then, Mr. Maweri, are you at liberty to tell us what other companies you are owning in a different environment to that of Zimbabwe? How is the company faring? And I mean, Chichafa, I'm not sure what that would add to the debate of 2004. What I'm doing has nothing to do and ought to have nothing to do with what is going on. And this is what we should be dealing with. We should have the courage to deal with the facts of today than deal with what a person is doing. I have no knowledge of who you are, what you are doing, and if you do something in your interest, fine, well and good. But you are talking about something that happened where Advocate Chamisa has weighed in on that. Do you think RGM knew your court case? I don't think anyone who be a president and know everything. He may have known of what he was told about the court cases, but I would not believe that he would know my side of the story. He would only know the side of the stories, but of the people who have access to him and unfettered access. So definitely, what I do know is he tried to intervene and he was overpowered. Mugabe era was animal farm type of life. Sidion Nyamtumbu. Mashu, you're right. The biggest mistake you made at the time was not to extricate yourself from the popular rumor at the time that you were a proxy of Mnangagwa running SMM on his behalf. You, June, that is, you can't extricate yourself from a falsehood. Well, if people believe what they believe, there's nothing I can do. But if the public power has been used wrongly and you keep silent, you must also own up. The facts will not change by the passage of time. The facts remain what they are. And if you are interested in the facts, you still have checked. It has nothing to do with me. Remember, there are thousands of people whose lives were affected by this. The moment it becomes me versus a public officer who is supposed to be a custodian or a servant of you, then there's something wrong with the system. This rumor gained traction and some of us believed it until you lost control of the company and you started setting the record straight. I am in hindsight to regret your association with PF at the time. There's nothing to regret. I can't associate with a body corporate. I was neither a member. I am not a member. I've never been a member of ZANU-PF. I said that. And if you want to check, just Google. And the facts are there, Eugene. The fact that you may wish, it's like Grace extricating herself from her husband. What was done was wrong. Whether Grace was a loud mouth, was offensive to your decency, doesn't make a difference. There was a transfer of power that did not involve the people. The party that vacated power has since spoken. Therefore, one cannot say anymore that Mugabe knew or voluntarily resigned. He is the one who is the actor. We can't speak on his behalf. He has already said that what happened, happened without my knowledge and consent. That's the story. That's the end of the story. It is not for us to guess. If I tell you that a law was passed, that law exists, Eugene. Go and look at the law and see whether it says Mutuma Mawere. It doesn't say so. It purports to be a law of general application. And that's what we ought to be talking about. That's what we need to be talking about. Chinasha Mpasira, I agree with the notion that the opposite of property is not wealth. Wealth is a store of value. Individuals aspire to work hard and store value where there's rule of law. Hashtag property rights. Grace Rurez, is it necessary, serious about these other companies? That's what we get. Then, Max, true, we need to know his take on expropriation of private property. All opposition need to be clear on this. Lied. Those looters left, right, and center. John James Ndoga, do you still support Mzuri? Yes or no? This is the kind of question that really undermines everything that we know about life. Why would I support an individual? What for? Support, then what does it make Mzuri? Do you really seriously think that my life is predicated on whether Mzuri, Chamisa, Mnangagwa is up or down? Do you really think life is about supporting a person, what they stand for? If there's something that Mzuri has said or done, what if you are referring to me interviewing Collins Changirai? Then talk about that. Ask about that. Why do you have to be this minimalist, this small-mindedness? Why? Why are people so concerned that they themselves would be sovereign, but they want to ask another person, what do you own? What do you do? How did you do this? And yet, themselves, they are free to support who they want to support. Why would I support an individual anyway? I'm very positive he didn't know what these culprits were up to. That may be the case. He may know what he was told. Like anybody else would be concerned to know what has happened. And he's given a story, whether the dummy or not. But it's a story. Even his coup d'etat was a dummy. He only discovered it afterwards. And other people are blaming him to say, why did you give up power when actually, you should have known better. He was told that the whole country is demonstrating. They want to come and finish you. If you don't resign, we can't protect you. Then a person has to make that call. And the opposite of poverty is not wealth, it's justice. That's right. The opposite of poverty is justice. It's one of Stevenson's most memorable lines. It's a bit bewildering at first, but that's part of its power. Look, like a good proverb, as it settles onto you, It clarifies the problem we face and the solution we need. It confronts a mistaken assumption that the opposite of poverty is wealth and points to a higher truth. Like Tinashe is saying, imagine you create wealth only to lose it to people who don't believe that the role of government is not to do what they do. Divine, you are on fire, Awere. Thank you. A law was crafted and passed with an agenda, but meets represented to RGM. We have to test it. We can't say it was misrepresented because he participated in it. And that's what we need to apply our minds to. Tichafa, no, my question helped to untangle this debate. We want to know whether if this saga around SMM had not happened, was the company going to be thriving given the economic trajectory that Zimbabwe has gone through? Think of it. I don't know what I don't know, Tichafa. I can't speculate what could have happened. And it's irrelevant if it's not your car, don't drive it. And then you say, it could have happened. It could have been an accident in future. Let's deal with legality and constitutionalism. Let us not occupy ourselves with assumptions of something that has happened. Tichafa, history is history. It's pregnant with facts and circumstances. The truth of the matter is the people who were working in 2004 are no longer working. The mine that was producing asbestos for sale is no longer producing. What could have happened then? Maybe there wouldn't be a need to have Zimbabwe open for the business, because it would have been open from then. There is nothing really that we gain by trying to shed the past, trying to give it some character that it doesn't have. What happened, happened. Let's learn from it. And by learning from it, it means we'll be able to think and apply our minds differently. So this is what we have. Grace says, let's discuss about law and order. Let's see the Company Act be reversed and deal with the culprit. I don't think you can revisit that. It's not, the Reconstruction Act that was manufactured, and it's not the Companies Act. If anything, the Companies Act stands on its own, does not require this innovation. So that's where we are. We are where we are because other people chose to take the law into their own hands. I think I've dealt with the issue of race. Let's use SMM to dig deeper into the rule of law questions. And I hope that what we have shared today will be able to ignite you. Stay word, Mawire. Same old story from ZANU-PF, retired. Let's have new government come September. All the companies that were shut down will be revived for real. Let's not wait until after the elections. Let us be vigilant. Let us know that what we may desire to be an outcome may be a nightmare. So let us not be complacent, never be complacent with the future that you have not seen. Don't be overconfident, because the future is not yours. All you can do is use your mind to enlighten, to ignite, to accelerate the mind to inform action. And I have taken note of what Advocate Chamisa has said. It's important, it's significant, and it's worth of praise, because it is when you throw in something into a space that is confused. Imagine there's 121 political parties. How many of them are concerned about what Advocate Chamisa said? How many of them would go on top of the mountain and say, what is wrong is wrong? Whether I become a president or not, it doesn't have to wait for me to be president to remove an injury. If it was repealed now, let's go back to Advocate Chamisa to say, please don't defer an injury to wait for God's grace to visit you. What if it doesn't visit you? What is unlawful, what is evil, what is unconstitutional must remain unconstitutional ab initio. In fact, Advocate Chamisa should be looking at himself in the mirror and say, why did it take 14 years for me to make a pronouncement of theft and to associate human beings with that grand theft? Why is it that we cannot not name and shame people? It is about time that we can name and shame. If Mugabe says he doesn't know it, then we agree with him that now that he knows, can he agree that he overstayed in government? Most of them are there to pull donor agencies, money, chetty, chet. Those are the political parties. That's what Grace is saying. We need to be vigilant. We need not to take things for granted. Mugabe in retirement is sought to wake up, to be at the forefront of constitutionalism. I have been, Linda Sibanda Mkusha, I've been to Shawane several times, and my heart bleeds at the lives affected by the closure of SMM. I hope it will bleed because we have not done anything to restore the rule of law. You don't have to go to a victim to know what it is like when people take the law into their hands. Disaster always follows. The infrastructure that is idle and the economic loss, all those things will happen, Linda. They will always be there. Our focus should be on property rights and get to the people who are there. Clopas Makaori. Mr. Mawai, there are so many things that went wrong at the eyes of ED, and so many. Yes, we must do something here now. That's what we have to do. We have to be alive that no person should be in government. Never again shall we allow another Mugabe to be there for 37 years, then come out of it ignorant, asserting a right that you should never had in the first place. We should not go back to those to trust in people with power. Even Mugabe today doesn't know what Chamisa is talking about. If he knew, he would have acted earlier. Perhaps he could have averted the coup. Perhaps he could have resigned earlier. to say, I failed the people of Zimbabwe. But he doesn't know what we know. So it is our job never to tire until he goes to his grave, knowing that he was part and parcel of the closure of SMM mines. And he can't escape it. He has to be brought to book himself. That there is no law that acquired life without him. Grace, Chokwadi Chinamasa is an evil. He's not the only one. Mugabe, all these people who in Kabi, Jonathan, all these people who were there, they know, they knew better, but they chose to close their eyes. We need to expose him. I've already started myself. Like that Kadungure was showing off his car today. I told him to come down and bring back Mawariri money, not Mawariri, Maweri. Maria Rawlings, welcome. So I think I've done justice on that. Good evening. Looking ahead, it's clear that unlawful acts and their promoters be held accountable. Yesterday even, I'm afraid politicking can inform, encourage, inspire, and empower. Thank you, everyone, for sharing. Right now, and if the Constitution of Zimbabwe and the Associate Acts mean anything at all, we have lawmakers on either side of the fence who enjoy mudslinging instead of applying the said law they have been elected to enforce. Save, enforce, and protect. There happens to be no law that holds politicians accountable on their promises, or if such a law exists, it is yet to be effective. Thank you. SMM was not the only company affected, as far as this was wrong. Let's debate with the focus of rectifying wrongs that were done so that the future can be bright. Yes. Let's talk about SMM. I'm here. That's why I'm talking about it. Because I got the facts. So, Tichafa, let's use one example to get somewhere. So that we can bring to book even using one example. Karin Swing, these posts are so valuable. Mutuma Mawere. Because your passionate and courageous thoughts are inspiring others to speak their feelings. These exchanges can inform, encourage, inspire, and empower. Thank you, everyone, for sharing. So, thank you, Karen. ZANU-PF has done so much harm to Zimbabwe. Not ZANU-PF. Let's not talk about ZANU. Let's talk about individuals who are evil. ZANU-PF has no legs, has no eyes, has no teeth. There's no legs. They are all corrupt and should not be in a position to be in government. Error should be Mawere, man. Kadungri was showing off standing on top of his car full. So you can see that the perimeter of foolishness has no end. And we need to understand. I always listen to Mtuma's programs. There's always something new to learn. Keep up the good work. Bernard, it's people like you and Karina and many others, Grace, and who are there just to keep us friendly, who every day ask me, when is the show? Sometimes I'm tired, but I have to keep up the promise to give up time to share this. I have other things to do, but in the interest of sharing, therefore, we need to be able to talk, and we may be able to discover more things than we thought we knew. Let's put it to progress. You saw the people who were selected to interview President Mugabe, mostly foreign. He will not come on our show to say, President, sit down, let's talk here. Cash talk. Let's not bullshit. Let's not talk about constitutionalism because we are injured. Let's talk about what kind of Zimbabwe you obtained under your watch. Did you know that the Zimbabwe you thought you were running well was rotten? Does he know what we know? And if he knows, this is the problem that we face. So here we are. We have Chamisa who has ignited us to bring this matter to the fore. And let's now weigh in and show Chamisa that the issue is not about assets. The issue is not about getting into government office to do something for me. I don't need a favor from anybody. But the country needs the truth. The people of Zimbabwe deserve the truth. And that's what we owe the people of Zimbabwe. The storytelling, the stories, the untold stories, so that the people of Zimbabwe can make their own decisions. That would be great if you can bring him on your show. He won't want, because the people who handle him, they think no Zimbabwean understands him. They want to bring a narrative that he's a victim. So they are parading him as a victim so that they can get into politics. Because without politics, there are many people who purport to support President Mugabe, yet they are looking for careers. Grace, this show gives you confidence. Less fear to say the truth. Can you bring Mugabe on your show? I can't bring people who are pop stars. They are managed by other people who think we are not worth anything. It's BBC, CNN, Al Jazeera, SABC. Those are the people who are respected. Imagine how demeaning it is for politicians to come on Mawere's show. They don't respect. They think we are parasites. They think we are criminals. That's why we have to be criminalized first. These people have no regard for anybody except themselves. Some people talk about SMM, but they can't even talk to me. They don't even want to have facts because they think they know the facts. Imagine somebody who has been in the wilderness for 14 years being told, wait for me for another 6 months so that I get into office, so that I cure you. Imagine I go to a doctor who tells me, not now. I will only be available to see you after 6 months. What would you say to that doctor? Politics is about now. Mugabe is not waiting until after the elections. He is saying, don't go to the elections with a thief. He's saying somebody stole my baton, and that somebody must own up that I've stolen. That's not right. So don't go to elections and say you want free and fair elections when you are holding something that you didn't get properly. Be proper, then go to election. That's what Mugabe is saying. And what is he being told? Go to court, you fool. And by the people who is telling him that. Even President Mnangagwa is smart enough not to insult Mugabe. Because without Mugabe being coaxed into resignation, what could have happened? Kill him. And then take over. Then say what? They need Mugabe more than he needs them. Because without Mugabe, there's a story to tell. Pamaguma pane nyaya, Mugabe akabva sei, iari mupenyu. Mugabe is alive to tell his own story. I'm also alive to tell my own story. So that is where the problem. Imagine Advocate Chamisa says, let's have a commission of inquiry that in the first 100 days, I want to have a commission of inquiry on SMM. Because I want the people of Zimbabwe to know the truth. Or even now to say, let's go for a commission of inquiry. President Mnangagwa, let's be open. Let Zimbabwe be open. And the first stage is, let us go for a commission of inquiry. Alas, nobody's asking. Everyone is talking about elections. Hey, how can you go for elections when there is a problem? How do we go for elections when there's a problem that needs to be fixed? Fix the problem. Then let's talk. But how many people? Let's talk to Advocate Chamisa. Let's build his confidence to be able to use the SMM example so that we can expose this hypocrisy, this duplicity. Let us not be afraid. Let us not be afraid. Let us take this seriously. Let us build a Zimbabwe. Let us, that is a memory. Is Chamisa not using political mileage? He has to use it. That's why it exists. In fact, we should encourage him. We should encourage him. We should encourage him to use it. We should encourage him. Any politicians, there are facts of SM that are embarrassing to Mugabe. There are facts that will be embarrassing to anyone who says Zimbabwe is open for business. There's a law. He is a parliamentarian. So if Chamisa is using SMM as political mileage, so let us encourage him to accelerate using it. Let us work with whoever wants to expose what is wrong. Let us help him become a president, because we don't want a president who has amnesia. We want a president who can tell what it is like. Mawire Mutiniri said more than 5,000 troops have been deployed to intimidate people. These elections will be bloody again, because opportunists in government don't want to go. If Mugabe is crying, let it not be Chamisa complacent and thinking that the grass is green, the playing field is level. It's not. That's why they had to remove Mugabe before elections, so that they can set state power and finish whoever thinks that they can destroy this narrative. This is serious game. There are people who have had no jobs for 14 years. And nobody cares. So please, this is not a picnic game. This is not a monkey business. There are people who don't have any other job except being in government. So if we are not careful, so it's not easy. The lawmakers, they are all scared to be fired. Some have been fired. So it's not easy. Zimbabwe anymore. There are people, there are MPs who have been castrated. because they are afraid. There are people in Zimbabwe who believe otherwise. So it's not easy. And you can't take anything for granted. We can't take anything for granted. This is what Zimbabwe is. And we can't be blind to the dangers that lie ahead. And we woke up one day, there was an administrator. If people can do it, they can do it. They can do it tomorrow. So let us not be complacent. Let us not be blind. Let us keep hope alive, but in hope, we have to work for the outcome that we desire. So I wish to thank all of you for being part of this conversation. Let's keep on talking. Let us never refuse to learn. So I hope every day as we meet and get closer and closer to the truth, you also be angry as I have been. You also be angry, not at the evil people, but at the silence of people like you and me. How many people have been silent? How many people have been thinking that someone in government, that the neighbor is the answer, that somebody else will give me legs to get where I want to get to, somebody else will give me his eyes so that I can see what I don't see, somebody's ears can hear so that I can hear better. Use your gifts. You are complete already to say something. You are the change that we've been waiting for. Let us not wait for Chamisa to ignite us. Let us be ignited, inspired, and excited just to say, no, not in my name. Whatever you want, do it. But excuse me. Don't do it in my name. Because there are many people who talk of Zimbabwe, but their actions are not open. Yet they say Zimbabwe is open for business. What is Zimbabwe without its people? What is Zimbabwe when other people think they alone have the power to promise that which they undermine during daylight? So let us be true to our word. Let us build a Zimbabwe that speaks to our spirit or our spirits. Because we are Zimbabwe. There cannot be Zimbabwe without the people. And the people are individuals. Let us go beyond talking at government or parties as human beings. Let us name and shame, like Advocate Chamisa has started doing. He is not afraid to be the voice that names the people who he thinks are responsible for outcomes that we all object to. Thank you very much.